The Union of African Shippers Council, in collaboration with the United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, UNCTAD, met in Abuja, Nigeria, to discuss issues affecting shippers in the region. The meeting began with an opening summit on the theme, Unfair Shipping Surcharges and High Local Shipping Charges on National Economy of West and Central African States. Vice President of Nigeria, Yemi Osinbajo, in his keynote address, called on African government to come together and adopt common political, diplomatic, and operational strategies that will positively impact on the economy of the sub-region. According to him, the West and central government must develop their country's transport infrastructure for a seamless implementation of the African Continental Free Trade Agreement. The Vice President was represented by Rotimi Amaechi, Minister of Transport, Federal Republic of Nigeria. The Executive Secretary and Chief Executive Officer of Nigerian Shippers Council, Hassan Bello, on his part, also noted that arbitrary and unilateral increase in charges would not benefit the operations and general procedures in our countries. He therefore called on the gathering to develop a strategy that will resolve pricing issues by creating an enabling environment for negotiations and agreement with stakeholders who provide shipping services.
It's important that the government encourages transparent processes and procedures and generally ensures that an efficient, competitive and friendly environment is created. This will sure result in cost reduction.
The second day of the meeting was a workshop to discuss issues on the International Maritime Organization Facilitation Convention, FAL Convention, and the International Maritime Organization Sulfur Limit of Fuel. The FAL Convention was to create awareness among the member council of the UASC on the importance of the FAL Convention in terms of the facilitation of the reception of vessels and its departure at ports. They used the opportunity to call on member councils to put measures in place to domesticate the FAL Convention in view of the benefit attached to the convention.
The FAL Convention was to create awareness among the member councils of the UAC on the importance of the FAL Convention in terms of facilitation of the reception of vessel and its departure at ports. Most of the member councils of the UAC are signatories to that convention. But unfortunately, none of us has domesticated the convention into our national law.
The workshop also sought to discuss the upcoming IMO sulfur limit regulation and the implication it brings with the increased bunker price and who bears the cost.
The truth of the matter is that at this point, research has shown that because this is going to increase the cost of operation for all the shipping vessels or shipping lines, there's a likelihood that it would impact on the level of freight. And a lot of the operators are going to go through the route of surcharges. So we expect that in a very, very near future, we're going to have an introduction of surcharges basically linked to this compliance.
Now, the third day of the meeting was the Joint Standing Committee meeting of the Union of African Shippers Council. The committee, which is divided into two folds, sought to address issues of arbitrary increase in charges and introduction of new nomenclatures by shipping lines. Then, a research studies and training on freight rates, surcharges and transport costs, and finally, the constitution of UASC group of experts that will negotiate charges with shipping lines.
There's a need for the shipping lines to recognize that without the cargo, they are not in business. And therefore, there's a need for them to look critically and ensure that shippers are part of the decision making when it comes to freight rates, surcharges, and local charges.
The three-day meeting ended with a grand gala night where individuals from West and Central Africa expressed satisfaction of the recommendation that came out of the topics of discussion.
It's been clear where the sub-region and the region as a whole wants to be. Their focus is clear, and I'm very sure that the years ahead are going to be great and bigger improvements for the sub-region.
It was an amazing one, so it was quite interesting and educating.
From Ghana, Cote d'Ivoire, Congo, Senegal, Benin, Togo, and even from the UK and a host of other countries. You can see it's highly successful.
As you can see behind me, this is the Gala Night to crown everything that took place here in Abuja, Nigeria, where the Union of African Shippers came together to have discussions on the issues of high local charges at the ports and surcharges that is affecting the industry, as well as the IMO regulations that is going to take place on 2020, come January 2020. It's been an amazing moment with Mark Focus on this show, as we do all the time. This is Maritime Minerals Aviation and Ports with me, Nanesi Wate. It's an amazing moment here in Nigeria, Abuja, where we have the largest market in Africa and the largest population with the biggest